Greetings, this is Richard Fleming, and this video is going to be a short overview on how to submit assignments to Desire to Learn for the Game 105 course. So, you've completed your Catch the Something assignment, and now you need to turn it in to the Dropbox so you can continue on with the course. How do you do that? Well, you can't just drag in the GameMaker project folder. If I try to go into the assignment, notice it'll say drop files here or click below. I'll just go ahead and move that off to the side. I'll grab my catch folder, attempt to drag it in here, and denied, invalid file type. You can't just drop the whole folder in there. So instead, we are going to have to compress this. Now, just as a personal preference thing, I don't really like the default archiver that comes built into Windows. It has this really nasty habit of nesting what you're trying to archive, so that if you are not paying attention and you do a couple decompress-compress cycles using the Windows Archiver, you'll end up with a directory that's like 10 levels deep. I really don't like it. It's not a very good compressor, to be honest. A good, legally free compressor is 7-Zip. It can compress to 7-zip format, as well as gzip, tar, and zip formats, zip being the most important one. And as you can see here, it can unpack a whole heck of a lot of things. So this is a pretty good free archiver that you can use. I like the user interface on WinRAR a little bit better than I do on 7-zip, but you need to pay for WinRAR. You really honestly do need to pay for that program. It's not freeware. So how can we use this to submit it in? Well, here's my project folder that I did while going through the demo. I'm just going to right click on this, go to 7-zip. I'm going to add to archive, or if you're feeling lazy, you can also just do straight add to catch.7z. I'm going to do add to archive. By default, it's going to be on the 7z format. I'm going to change that over to zip, and I'm just going to leave everything else as defaults. Hit OK. It'll think for a moment. And then I'll have my nice little zip folder there for my archive. Come back over here, drag this into the upload area, and watch the upload bar slowly creep up. Now you're going to have some patience here, potentially. If you're doing this on campus, it should be, you know, near instantaneous. I'm currently trying to do this over a Wi-Fi connection, so it takes a little bit longer. And there we go. I can see that it has been uploaded. You don't have to put a comment in here, but if you've got any specific things that you want to say to me about the assignment, feel free to include them here. And then you hit Submit to Dropbox. And verify that you get this submitted successfully message down here on the bottom. You want to see that. You should also be able to tell, if you come back later to look at it, and you come in here and you look at it, you click on it, you should see submissions, catch.zip, meep. So you should see your submission here. Now you can submit multiple times. Let's say the first time you submit, it was late, you were tired, and you compress the wrong folder. It actually won't let you submit without uploading something. You have to upload something. But maybe you just uploaded the wrong thing. Maybe you uploaded your English assignment instead of the game project. No worries. Just come back in and do another upload. That's fine. Make sure, if I've got multiple uploads, that you put in the comments why I have multiple uploads and which one am I supposed to be using. Other than that, it's a pretty simple process, and so that concludes this video.